Welcome everybody, Gareth Jones here from Paris Technologies. Today I have a little video for you on bottom-up, top-down budgeting. I think we've all learned about this in our studies, and you know, when I was learning about this 30 years ago, I thought, wow, there must be companies out there that are adopting top-down and companies out there that are adopting bottom-up, and I wonder what makes that team choose one of those. Fast forward 30 years, and I can tell you that both of these concepts exist in most business simultaneously. Mostly people start at the bottom, and they've got little experts in a small part of the business, and they've maybe got formulas, maybe they've got artificial intelligence if they advanced, and they build this budget from the bottom up. Then a group of accountants like you and I are going to get together, and they're going to consolidate all that detailed forecasting and budgeting, and they're going to come to a consolidated result. We're going to take that up the chain to the board, we're going to take it to the shareholder, we're going to take it to the senior management decision makers. They're going to look at this consolidated number, and they're going to not like some of the numbers. And they're going to say, no, change this number, change this number, change this number. And they're going to push from the top down. Now, we're going to have to take this targeted top-level number, and we're going to have to somehow get it to the bottom. Now, if you've built your models in Excel, very, very difficult. You're going to have to go down to the bottom. You're going to have to change some assumptions, roll it all up, check if you got to the number. If you didn't, you go down to the bottom again, and you roll it up. This sort of circular process in some organizations that I've worked with can take months. It's very expensive, it's very time consuming, and it's very demoralizing. However, if you use a different technology, this can be a much, much easier process, right? Today I'm going to show you us using our free version of our PowerExcel technology. I'm going to show you how you might tackle something like this, and I think it's going to give you some really great ideas. Hopefully you can incorporate them in your work, and it's a benefit to you and your company. Okay, let's look at it. So we've talked about the theoretical top-down, bottom-up budgeting. And if you've ever had to do it, you'll know that trying to do it in Excel is a real nightmare. Let me show you how you might do it in a different tool. Today I'm using PowerExcel, our free version. Very, very powerful tool. It's free. I would really encourage you to try it and use it. It's gonna be able to help you in so many areas, this being one of them. And I'm just gonna give you an example, very simple example of what it can do. So let's have a look. All right, so here we've got a really simple, I've got a sales account, and I've got, I'm filtering on the account. I've got month and department. So I've got all my departments down to total department, but all my months across. And my team's gone out, and they've really done a good job at the bottom up level, and they've created a sales forecast of $12,000. And we've shown it to management, we've shown it to the board, and the board's come back and said, no, I can't live with anything less than 15,000. Now, that's your top down. How are we gonna change it? You know, the old system would be to go and wrestle with all these numbers now, and these guys have done a lot of thinking behind these numbers. They're really happy with the phasing, potentially. It's a problem, right? With our technology though, I can say, well, apply that, and basically using a formula that we've all agreed to, that we all believe in, it's gonna apply an equitable analysis. So what we've done now is I've pushed the 15,000 down, and I always call it a squeeze, because basically depending on your formula and depending on the rounding errors, it doesn't quite get there, right? But we got really close. I got really close in a second. Now, I can say, well, now we're going to rebuild from the bottom up. And we can start asking ourselves the question, which ones do we want to change? And potentially, we have a go-to where we've got to add 14. So, you know, I can do a little bit here. I can do a little bit there. And one more, let's say, okay, 202. And I've got to my 15, right? So it's really powerful, right? And I just want to show you one more time. So let's just say we want to change that to 16,000. I'm going to say apply. And then I'm going to say, well, I'm going to manipulate a little bit. It's still at a high level. I'm going to say, make that 1,000. Make that 1,000. Make that 1,000. And apply that. So it pushed, it squeezed everything really close, right? Then I can turn off my top down, and I can come in and apply some
wherever I want, 44.87. And depending on the roundings, we're going to get to where we want to be. Right. So that's the kind of idea. When you with this technology, you can do this type of bottom up, top down. It's very quick. It's very equitable. It's done by a formula. And as you can see, you can do it. You're going to do it both ways. You're going to push down or squeeze, as I call it, and then you're going to build it back up again. And you're going to have this really detailed bottom up budget that matches with the top down that you're getting pushed from your bosses. And everything's going to work across every department, across every region, whichever, whatever, however your business is segmented, you can just push it down using your formula that's agreed and equitable spreading method. And you're going to push it down really quickly, and then you're going to be able to analyze it and make it perfect. Saves a lot of time in a real life, real world scenario. None of this done in Excel. As you can see, all of this information is just visually displayed here. If I delete it and calculate it, it's there. If I try to change a number that's being held together by the engine, it won't let you. So it's a very controlled environment, a very powerful engine, and a very awesome example of how you can use this technology to save yourself a lot of time and a lot of heartache. So if you've got a business that has less than 500 accounts or less than 500 departments, I would really encourage you to try our free version. If your business is more complicated than that, then please reach out to me on LinkedIn, look on our website. We've got paid versions of our product. We've got great consultants with years and years of experience that can really help you, and you're going to have some great productivity gains within your company.